Oliver Achila grew up a few miles away with a different name and a different family. She narrates she was picked from a home in Wijama village, Lira City, ending up in Amolata district. Achila narrates how she was mistreated by the families she stayed with and how she had to make bricks to pay her school fees and later saved by Pastor Job Olara.
Achila Oliver, the name I was given from home. Then the other name that they changed when I was no longer living with my parents is the Abel Farida Martha. In a certain year that I don't recall, when I was still very young, there's one of the women, by then my mother was having a certain small business and she was selling like tomatoes, silverfish, and she was washing the clothes inside because we were staying inside the wall fence. She sent me to go and check to whether the neighbor, what the customers is outside, so that I can come and tell her. When I reached outside, I found there was a woman who was coming in front of me, and I was together with this young brother of mine because I was the firstborn. This woman came and she started asking me whether I know a certain market which was in front of us. And that market right now I can't recall because I was still very young. I told the woman that I know the market, and she told me that if you know the market, please you direct me, you take me up to that place. I had to take this woman up to the marketplace. Now when we reach there, this is the woman who refused. She told me that no, this is not the market that I want. I want another what? Another market. So let us proceed. We continue with our moving. I was kept inside for like 2 weeks that I was not coming out.
Pastor Job Olara of Kiriandongo, who helped to accommodate the girl and pay her fees for the last 2 years to complete her O-level last year. Lambert Francis Okello, the crime intelligence officer at Amolata, says he spearheaded the investigation and tracking down of the suspect.
In Amolata, when I was not here even, but when the girl was from Kiriandongo last year, the Kiriandongo people failed. So the only option they did was to send the girl back here to Amolata, where with my techniques I had to start from zero. Enough records were here, and none of the girl knew where she was being staying, and she was nurtured. The girl told us the person who stole her from Lira in 2006-2007.
In abbreviation of CFCU, so I cannot recall the date very well. I got a report from my crime intelligence, by then he had gone for a leave, informing me that there was a girl who was referred from Kiriandongo police station to Amolata CPS. So he was telling me the girl looked someone who was kidnapped when she was still young.
Irene Akot, a police officer at Kiriandongo, says they handed over the child to the parents for a matter to be handled in Lira.
So that case was registered in Lira in 2008.
So in Kiriandongo, when you got the child, what action did you take?
The child was handed over to the parents who were supposed to report back to Lira. After them producing documents, photographs, proving that the daughter was theirs. So the girl was handed over to them and told them to report and officially inform Lira CPS.
Thomas Otim, the child's biological father, now a resident of Camp David in Lira City West Division, says her daughter was stolen on March 23rd, 2006, and their search was in vain, and they gave up. On March 23rd, 2006, my wife was washing clothes inside a wall-fenced premise when our daughter was kidnapped. My wife also used to sell small items like tomatoes, groundnuts, outside the premise on the roadside. That fateful day, she asked Oliver and Ivan to go and attend to the business as she washes their clothes for Easter. I also left for my second home in Amoka, where I have another wife. After about 3 hours, I got a call that Oliver has disappeared. I was told that a young boy says a woman took Oliver on a bicycle. I went and reported to the police. And later, I made announcements with Radio Unity, Radio Wa, and Radio Lira. I also shared a photo of my child on social media recently on January 5th, 2023. My brother, Godfrey Opiri, who remained in junior quarters where I previously resided, rang me at 5 p.m., informing me that they've discovered my child. I had mixed feelings at the moment, but I asked to talk to my daughter, and she asked me if there is anything I could use to identify her. I told her to check on her birth mark and her armpit. At this point, on seeing the mark, she broke down in tears and we both got extremely emotional. I told her that I have her photos while she was young, her birth certificate and baptism card. In a twist of events, Otim was in the process of barring his son, who had been killed in a road accident. He was in a very confusing state since he had lost a child but discovered another who had been missing for 17 years. At Lira CPS, Oliver was handed over to his father, who was asked to record a statement after burial. Rose Oroma, the mother, says she was living in anguish all the 17 years her daughter was away, but had hope that her child was alive and not dead. She narrates the pain she went through. When my child got lost, my neighbor advised me to try getting help from some pastor where she used to go for prayers. That pastor can pray and tell whether the child is dead or alive. But later, I realized I was being conned and I decided to stop going to this pastor. I told my husband I could not return to this lady. I was devastated by the loss of my daughter for 1 month. I couldn't eat or drink without being forced. All I did was pry for her state, for her safe return. I continued praying and living in a solitary life with no one to stand with me. Instead of getting consolation, my husband summoned my father and handed me over to him that he does not want to see me, even threatened to cut me with a panga. I went back to home in Gulu. I stayed home for 1 year and 6 months, but later I started a business and decided to console myself. We later reconciled, but it was not easy for me at the moment. Now that my daughter is back, I am trying to recover what I know. I will take time to fully heal and get over this shock. Sanja Omar says she has no connection to the disappearance of the child. She says she got the child from a friend and took her to a grandmother in Amulata after the friend disappeared. In 2006, I was still in school, and in 2008, a lady called Okello Eunice, Okello Christine, a friend I was staying with in Kitugum, came with her child and left her with me. Then she eloped with a soldier. I tried to connect with her, but in vain, and I decided to go to the child's home in Amulata to my grandmother, who contacted the police. I only helped Oliver to locate her family by getting her uncle's number. I paid her fees from primary 1 to senior 4 at Langon College as she searched for her parents. Together with my brother, we traced for Oliver's family. The family should appreciate because we looked after Oliver until the pastor picked her up from our home. Also, her parents accepted. I released a bond because I explained the story. Report by Hudson Aponyu for the news.